People, here we go.
We are back. This game, Saskatoon's Walter Murray Marauders versus the St. Francis Xavier Rams out of Edmonton. This game, the winner of this game is going to decide our last semi-finalist.
Okay.
One of the semi-finals is already figured out.
Holy Cross, one just now.
Just one to seal their spot. They're going to play Raymond out of Tabor, Alberta tomorrow at 1:30.
Tabor, or is it Raymond, Alberta? Or are they near Tabor? I don't even know.
They're Southern Alberta somewhere. Their name's Raymond, whatever. They're good at basketball. I know that.
They are good.
But the winner of this game is going to take on Riffle from Regina. Ooh. And that's going to round out our final four here on the A side.
Okay. Riffle looked sharp.
Riffle looked really good. And scouting reports tell us it's a real coin flip between them and Holy Cross for sort of the top-ranked team in the province.
Okay.
Not necessarily in the tournament, because there's too many unknowns here with some of these out-of-province teams, but in the province of Saskatchewan, at least, kind of ranked one and two. Walter Murray's kind of a 3-4 ranking in the province.
Okay, but they do have some young powerhouse players.
Totally. Totally.
I've heard some things.
Do I start at the top and work down? I guess I'm going to start off with a few things. Number 13, Faisal Mahadi, grade 10 guard. He played all game the last game. Dylan Morin, number 3, grade 11 guard. Little guy, but just works and scores. There's too many people to name, but their big name, Zach Hawley, number 1, grade 9 guard.
Okay.
At grade 9, he doesn't play like a grade 9.
All right, and his father is
Scott Hawley,
the second coach
in on the bench there.
Okay, well, here we go. St. FX out to an early 3-0 lead. I'm assuming Walter Murray will score something. Like, we're not going to end the game 3-0.
No, that's not a typical basketball score. Zach Hawley of the Walter Murray Marauders, we were just talking about, number one grade 9 guard. He actually won the 3-point competition.
I saw that
today
at the pep rally. That was exciting.
Wasn't it?
Oh, it got me pepped. But now the Brit Dogs have got me needing Pepto-Bismol.
Okay, if you were me, both these water bottles are half full. I'm going to go with the positive spin. They're both half full.
Yes, yes.
I'm not sure which one is mine.
Do you roll the dice?
Yeah, I do.
There's still a full day of basketball ahead of you.
No, so I'm going to pour one into the other. I just don't know which one to pour into that. Which one? Would you
Does
pour the left
matter?
One into the right?
I don't know which is more sanitary. I think you're going to get sick either way. I wouldn't roll
one
that dice.
One of them was mine, though.
Oh, okay. So you only have a 50% chance here? Folks.
I'm a gambler. I'm doing it.
Okay. To the charity stripe, number 9, Joel Secchi. All right.
St. Francis up 6-0. Similar storyline to yesterday's Walter Murray game. Walter Murray's down 7-0 really early, and then, well, they didn't let that get to them. They just clawed their way back and won the game.
That's right. That's
and
right.
I am predicting they do the same thing here tonight.
Okay. For all you St. Francis Xavier fans, if you're tuning in via the live stream, if we are mispronouncing names or got the names wrong, please let us know in the live chat. It's always great to say people's names correctly. I believe, you know, mothers and fathers pick names for their children. Expect them, you know, be like calling me Bill. It's William.
It's William. And of course, we're going to make mistakes. We never do it on purpose. We're
I haven't
never
made one
it.
In 20 years, but I'm due.
This might be your year.
It could be. Oh, making it look easy again there, Joel Secchi. Okay, Walter Murray waiting to get on the board here.
Dylan Morin.
And if you don't
set something, look at this nifty spin move.
And they're on the board.
Gets it to go.
For those that don't know, these quarters, only 8-minute quarters at Brit.
They
trying
go
to
by
squeeze
quick.
In, squeeze in the games. Yeah, they do. You don't want to fall behind too
and
early.
Number 4, Kalen Smith. For the Rams, gets the 2 and the foul.
And 1.
Hey, already people chiming in on the live stream. Predicting FX to lose is not a smart pick. I agree with that, actually.
And I love the emoji.
Totally. And this is just, I'm a dreamer. I got a big piece of my heart at Walter Murray.
Dreaming's free.
I know some of these fellas. I have to cheer for them, but you're absolutely right. If you gave me $100 and
He'd
said I had
it.
To bet on someone, it'd be tough to bet against St. FX. They looked great last night. They're big, they're fast, they're athletic.
If my memory serves me correctly, they were up against, yes.
St. Joe's.
Out of Saskatoon here, that's right.
That was actually a really good game.
Yeah, the 7 o'clock game, correct.
Kudos to St. Joe's, too. I kind of thought early on, I was like, uh-oh. Early on, I think we saw, like, an alley-oop dunk in the first minute for St. FX and, like, a huge three. And, like, it got pretty ugly really quickly. And I thought, uh-oh, this might be bad. But Joe's hung in there.
They did. They hung around. I mean, it's always tough to balance these brackets out when you got teams from other provinces. You know, Brit being the premier event that it is, teams are clamoring. Email inboxes are full.
Bursting. Dejo Fountain.
Wanting that golden ticket, the invitation. Oh, big steal.
Mahadi to Fountain.
All right.
He's going to give him another 2. That's 4 in a row for him.
Looks like Walter Murray's brought a bit of a crowd with them, which is always nice to see. Those local crowds help keep the atmosphere up.
Walter Murray knows how to pack a gym.
Well,
Dejo Fountain. To Dylan Morin, he's going to put it up.
I know how to pack a few things, mainly my bags.
You're leaving.
When I get tossed out.
Fountain can't believe it. A look of disbelief on
his
face.
Yes, it is. That is disbelief. All right, the Rams are clapping. All right, 13-6. So, yeah, looking ahead, we still have another game after this one tonight, I believe.
And we do, yeah. It's on the B side here.
Right.
That's right. We were talking about this. Carlton.
Oh.
Who lost tonight at 5 o'clock in a really exciting game.
They
lose,
good.
They go to the B side, and they have to play to 9 at 9:30.
Oh.
So their first game, and a couple of the players on the Carlton team didn't leave the court, with the exception of the last minute when they kind of knew it was out of reach. So these guys played an entire game of basketball. They get a three-hour break and got to come back and do it again.
That is the nature of the bracket here, though, right? Because they did get the bye. So
yep.
Had they won, they'd be playing tomorrow.
They'd be playing tomorrow
at
3.
Yes. But yeah, that loss, that's probably the toughest. That's some tough medicine there.
That's a quick turnaround. Yeah. I don't care who you are or how athletic you are.
Yeah, I shovel the driveway and I'm done.
Go. Oh.
I'm not going to go out 3 hours later and shovel it again.
No.
Although I did that over the break.
And even that, like when I shovel the driveway, I shovel at a moderate pace.
Yes.
I don't get the pace.
I'm not going
these
up and down the
go.
Court. That's right. Sneakers squeaking. All right. At the line. Sean Brodeur. I've often wondered about the rubbing of the soles of the shoes. Is it nervousness? Does it apply grip? Look, they're all doing it.
No, it definitely applies grip.
Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes I would even
spit
on my hand.
I've seen it in baseball as
give
well.
Give them a little,
okay,
you know, rub
okay.
the hands together
like
and then wetten up the bottom of the
gotcha.
Shoes.
Gotcha. Okay.
Maybe you're not allowed to these days.
I don't know. Rules change. They tend to.
What's going on here?
I don't know. A bit of a delay. He's got his finger up.
A little chit chat.
Like, he's like, shush.
Shh, guys.
Shh. I'm in charge here.
Give me that. Sean Brodeur missed it. Rebound picked up
all
by
right.
Abde Tagheri. Dylan Morin's going to have it at the top. Oh, gets his pocket picked.
Now, this gentleman can dunk. I've seen it with my own eyes.
You want to. Eternity Igagwe.
Yeah. Eternity. Love it.
That's awesome.
Forever. That's an eternity, right? That's a long time.
I believe those are synonyms.
Yeah. Interchangeable words for those of you who have the kind of the same meaning. All right, eternity to the line here.
He's going to shoot two.
All right, now I've been unable to do this. It does preview. Sorry, folks, trying to give you guys the
backboard count.
Yeah, and they don't seem to let me.
Not working.
They've taken away my admin privileges. Monkeying around too much on day one. Took it away.
Ho! Dylan Morin again.
Having some issues with the scoreboard, I see. We're getting some complaints from the live chat. Yeah, it is currently 15-6, not 6-5.
Holly from the corner, 4-3.
That kid is automatic.
Showing why, oh, they're only giving him two.
Okay.
Long two, that's about as long a two as you can get.
Mm-hmm.
Rams offense working it around here. Looking for an in, oh, just Mahadi just about picked the pocket of that one, nope. Fontaine grabs the air ball. Holly's got it. Pull up jumper. Missed. No rebound. Igagwe gets it.
15-8. Things
to
are heating
Compo.
Up.
Compo drives and gets it. Holly to Morin. Morin's going to drive. Oh, surrounded. Back to Holly. Whoa, nifty move at the top. Creates some space. Gets it to Mahadi in the corner. Back up to Morin. Misses. Wide left.
17-8. Murray's going to want to watch the three-point game and maybe just go with the simple 2 points.
Sagiri.
You know? Oh, here we go. Sets up.
Oh, Dylan Morin.
Beautiful.
Just as you're saying, maybe they abandon the three, they get it.
Right.
But you're right. I wonder if it's like you're down and you think that you have to kind of make a few threes, but there's lots of game left. We're still in the first quarter.
There's so much strategy involved. Mind-boggling. All right, folks, for those of you viewing, we are in touch with our crew in the back. We know that there's been some issues with the scoreboard. All right, so we're going to get that cleared up. And don't worry, you're in good hands.
You are in good hands.
We have some amazing tech crews behind the scenes here. Crew.
And volunteer, an all-volunteer tech crew. And I think, you know, 5, 6, 7 cameras around the gym, microphones everywhere. All set up by volunteers. I'll run this entire tournament by volunteers who put in the hours from the start to finish.
Including yourself.
Including myself, yep. But I mean, it's not work if you love it, is it?
That's right. Sometimes I get voluntold. Yeah. But I'll do as I do. I just do it.
Truth.
All right.
We got timeout, St. FX.
19-11.
Enjoying, yeah, 8-point lead here. Minute 32 left in the first quarter.
All right.
8 points. Like, that can be erased. Give Walter Murray 30 seconds.
That's like 2 3-pointers and 2 free throws.
Wait.
Boom.
Just wait. Let me ask.
I just
I got
did the math.
Paper.
I okay, checked, two, I checked three, on my fingers. We're
three
good.
3 plus 3. And then what did he say?
3 plus 3 plus 2.
Plus 2 is, yeah. Just wait. Carry the.
Yeah.
No, you're right. That's 8.
Yep.
So 2 3-pointers.
Yep.
And 2 1-pointers.
Yep.
Holy. This
back in it. Tied up.
He's
all
good.
Knotted up. So
he's
nobody's running away with this one as of yet. 1:32 left in the first quarter.
Music's pumping. Gym's packed here on a Friday night.
It was after the elementary students earlier this afternoon. I was like, I walked into the gym. I'm like, ah, there it is. The Brit funk was in the air. Yeah.
And there is a certain
I was
mist in the air when you get 1,500 people in a hot gym, isn't there?
It's all these little kids with their snow boots and skidoo suits. I'm like, it's not even that cold out.
No, you're right. We're, yeah, we're blessed with some great weather this year.
You know how kids are. They're always layered. All right.
To Gary to Morin. Morin looking for some room to 3 seconds on the shot clock. What to do? Trapped. Gets the ball stolen. Tries to get it back. Doesn't.
Ooh. Nice play to salvage it there. Number 10.
Oh, again. Igagwe.
Tristan Thompson showing some athleticism. Saving that ball.
Looking to turn this into a 3-point play.
Oh my goodness, 21-11. Bear with us, folks. We'll keep you apprised of the score. Walter Murray, Saskatoon's own Walter Murray.
Got to give a shout out to Mark.
Oh, Mac Attack.
Mac Attack.
Yes.
Mac Attack, who's right now he's talking to Brit Chair Nicole Poyer right behind the score table.
Yes, yeah.
Mac Attack volunteers his time to help coach the Walter Murray Marauder team. He's him and Marauder coach Scott Hawley have worked together for quite a few years with the club team coaching Scott's
right.
Son Zach,
yes,
who's number one, who's this grade 9 kind of star here. So they've worked together for a long time. This is Mark's first year coaching at Walter Murray, and he's loving it. And this is his first Brit as a coach.
Right. Add that to the resume.
Competed in a couple Brits as a Bedford Road student. Came back and has been volunteering his time at Brit for years. Finally, he gets a chance to sit on the bench.
Wow.
And direct some traffic.
And really soak it in.
Shout out. Hello.
That was big. And of course, we'd be amiss not to mention Walter Murray's head coach.
Kirk Jones.
The prestigious. The one. The only.
The only.
Yes. Kirk Jones.
The reigning, defending. Kirk Jones knows
and
how to coach.
Still.
He coached here at Bedford for 7 years back in the 80s, 90s, somewhere around that time. Mm-hmm. So he's got lots of Brit experience here as a coach, but I mean, tons of coaching beyond that, right? I mean, 5-year Husky, Canadian dunk champ, played professionally briefly, won a CBL ring as an assistant coach with the Rattlers. Like, the list goes on and on. The guy knows basketball. What I'm saying is the guy knows basketball.
He does. And he looks like a basketball player. He's passionate.
57 years old. That's a 57-year-old I wouldn't want to fight. I wouldn't want to tangle with that guy.
No. That's why they say, and still.
He can still dunk.
Yeah. And still. There it is. Walter Murray heating up a little here now as the first quarter drips away. 22-16.
Trying to press. Foul called on Mahadi. Mahadi the hottie.
Yeah, keep your hands off Mahadi. All right, to the line again.
Eternity.
He's been there a few times. It feels like he's been up there in eternity. He's always at the line.
He is always up there.
Yeah.
Ooh. I think if you're always at the free throw line, that's a sign you're a pretty good player.
Hey, they're fouling you.
Yep.
Yeah.
That means they haven't figured out other ways to stop you, so they got to hack you,
yep,
I guess.
That's how it goes.
It's an honor, maybe.
Bring out the weed whacker.
He hits
Making
them both.
It look simple. 24-16, Walter Murray.
Under 10 to go. 5 seconds left.
Oh my.
2 seconds, buzzer beater for Holly, hits it!
That was vital.
That's what I'm talking about, and you're right, that was vital.
Yeah, 24-19.
In this game, it's a game of momentum. One shot like that at the right time can change the tides of the rest of the game. I'm not saying it's going to, but it can.
Turning the tides?
Is that?
Wow.
No?
Geological disturbances.
Is that another thing that people say?
I think it's a fantastic metaphor.
Don't?
No, I think okay. You did. It's sayable.
I guess.
I think we should say something about some of the sponsors that have
kicked up. Where do you want to start with our
sponsors? I think I'll start at the top. That's where I usually start.
Boom.
Dakota Dunes Community Development. What would we do without them? Cameco,
energizing a clean air world.
Trail Appliances.
For appliances.
And more.
And more.
Yeah. Sastel, thank you for your support. Laser Auto Body, probably making a killing on these icy days. Nobody's speeding out of here. Yeah, but feel free to speed down to Brit. Get yourself a Brit dog.
You're right. Eh? Actually, speaking of Laser Auto Body, we're supposed to get some freezing rain tonight.
Oh, perfect.
Laser Auto Body's licking their chops right now. They're hoping for it.
Definitely.
I mean, I want to support Laser Auto Body, but I really don't. You know?
Ham Construction, we thank you for your construction services. Of course, Culligan Water.
The best water around. Breck Construction.
Yes, for the scaffolding that we sit on.
The very scaffolding we are enjoying resting on right now.
I hope they, their finest put this together.
Oh, Smiley's Buffet. Smiley's put together an amazing spread for the breakfast this morning. All the basketball teams, the dignitaries, the hostesses, all had this big breakfast this morning. Linklater spoke at it. Smiley's provided the buffet.
Awesome.
You know what would be an interesting stat? 12 basketball teams, let's call it 40 volunteers. How many eggs went into that breakfast?
Do the math. Put it in the live chat. Maybe you'll win something.
Yeah, but I bet you some of these high school guys had 8 eggs themselves.
Oh, easy.
Look at the size of these kids.
Oh, easy. And of course, we'd be amiss not to mention Husky Athletics and, last but not least, Me Sports. Second quarter.
One more.
Walter Murray pressing.
Mahadi's going to take it baseline.
Slipped out of his fingers.
Oh.
St. FX ball. All right. Both teams going with the tuck again. I think that's sort of the standard
tuck the
fashion.
Shirt.
Yeah. St. FX playing very organized basketball.
Eternity's got it. Puts it up. Little floater. Tipped in by Sean Brodeur. Tagari to Fontaine. Oh, in and out.
We've lost access to our chat. I can't see what our fans out there are saying.
A lot going on
behind the scenes.
Joel Seke. Tell you, just kind of looking not only on the court but at the rosters, and this is a familiar storyline we're going to hear. Walter Murray outsized.
Okay.
They're not a big team. They're fast. They're really skilled. But I think in most games, they're going to be the smaller team.
Okay.
And this St. Francis Xavier team, well, they're big. Not the biggest team at the tournament, but they are big.
Yeah. Number 6 for Walter Murray. That's got to go. Datiel?
Datiel. He picked up a rebound there, making up for it on the defensive end.
And he's got great flow.
Holly.
Again, doesn't go.
Tagiri couldn't get it to go.
Walter Murray snake bit here a bit.
Outside to Seke for 3. No good. Rebound up for grabs. It's a scramble for it. Holy cow. A couple Brit volunteers had to dive roll out of the way there.
Woo, showing some agility.
Including community school coordinator Carol Whitecalf and head admin assistant Tracy Bessie.
Big shout out to Tracy Bessie.
Just about ended up as wallpaper there on the baseline. Quick. Those ladies are quick.
Yeah. You don't need them turning into a puddle.
Those guys flying at me, I could be pretty quick too.
Oh,
that's a matter of life and death right there.
Yeah, I think you would, it's instinct at that stage.
Kaylin Smith.
Eternity.
One-handed. Back to Smith from the corner.
Nope.
Rebound up for grabs. It's a jump ball. Good fight.
Yeah.
Good fight for
I
both
like
guys.
It.
I like that.
Number 11 there, Sean Brodeur. Leaving a bit of sweat on the floor.
Dave Chill, Fontaine, number 6 for Walter Murray. Big on the rebounds. He's kind of he's their big guy. He's the guy they're relying on, I think, under the basket.
Oh,
he's
right.
Working on the defensive end tonight, that's for sure.
I see former administrator for Bedford Road, Dave Fisher.
Legend.
The man, the myth, the legend. Looking good.
You know what? He was working the
ticket booth.
The ticket booth.
That's right.
Principal here for a couple years.
Doing his
time.
Loves
it. Obviously a fan of Britt. Comes back and volunteers every year. And that, my friends, is the name of the game for Britt is volunteerism.
It is. And I just got a message from DJ Iceberg listening in from home. We miss you here.
He's
down with the sickness. Missing out on Britt 53.
Tough one. And you know, speaking about, you know, people coming back and volunteering. Yesterday I come walking in, Tom Sargent, Walter Murray principal, obviously, of course, former Bedford Road principal, former Bedford Road teacher, former Bedford Road coach. He's back here selling tickets at the gate. I come in today, Brent Hills, deputy director of our division, former principal of Bedford Road. He's here selling tickets.
It's good to see everybody kicking in.
I guess it goes to show, like, it doesn't matter how important you are.
That's right. Everybody's doing their part.
You come back and everyone's doing their part to make Britt happen.
That's right. Britt happens.
Whether you want it to or not.
That's right.
It's like a train, baby. Get out of the way.
Ooh,
it's coming.
Speaking of trains.
Wow.
Eternity bumped into number 6 there for Walter Murray.
Bumped? That's what you call a bump. Let me bump you like that.
Okay,
so
well,
like
hey,
it.
I'm sure Laser Autobody will take care of all my needs. Gym getting a little warmer.
Yeah, it is getting warmer. I love it. This is I would say the biggest crowd we've seen so far, and you know it's only going to get bigger tomorrow,
especially if local teams move on to the A side.
Especially, and we know Holy Cross has a spot in the semifinal. If Walter Murray can win, they have a spot in the semifinal. But you're right. It's always when those Saskatoon teams can make it later into the tournament.
Little Taylor Street rivalry there.
That is a Taylor Street rivalry. We already got Regina Riffle, who solidified their spot in the semifinal. They're watching this game closely to see who they're going to take
Licking
on.
Licking their chops.
They're a good team. Holly. Chris Cross. What? A Chris Cross will make
ankle
a jump.
Breakers.
Jump.
A kid can
play.
Wow,
nice move.
So you want to be a baller.
The guy dribbles like me.
A re-
Except he can do it with both hands.
I can see where he got it. 31-27 here.
Oh, Seke. Joel Seke.
33-27 now.
Dylan Morin has it.
Viewers at home not getting the overlay, I don't believe.
Under 4 minutes left in the first half. To Holly. He's been clutch here from three. Hey, nice rebound from Eunice. Back to Morin. It's in.
Oh, my. We got ourselves a basketball game, folks. Three points.
We're a one-possession game right here. Seke trying to keep it in. What's the call? Oh, couldn't keep it in. That's a Walter Murray ball. Timeout.
I disagree with that call, but what do I know?
Walter Murray clawing back.
All right, we're going to let you all listen to the sounds of the gym.
Let's do it.
Okay, folks, we are back.
3-point game. Walter Murray's been kind of clawing back here. Got to give a few shout-outs.
Oh, you do you? Shouting
yes,
out.
Yes, I do here. To my left here, we got a bunch of Walter Murray staff here.
Good to see supporting us,
Jack
Walter Murray
Sloboda,
Athletics.
Taylor Johnson, Joyce Glazel, Linda Marcott. We got a crew here.
Wow, cheering. you know their names.
And I know there's more Walter Murray staff sprinkled out throughout here.
Your principal, your administrators across the way.
Oh, that's right. Tom Sargent, Kevin McNarland. And this just goes to show you, this tournament is so much better. This is a Friday night, folks.
Yeah, they could be at home.
With their families. They're here.
Supporting.
Cheering on their students. Supporting the tournament. Like, that's what kind of tournament it is. And I love if people are at home listening to the live stream. I absolutely love that.
I don't think they are. I'm sure they're on mute by now.
You're right. Watching the live stream on mute is probably a more accurate description. But if you are watching the live stream on mute, from your home in Saskatoon, I'm going to challenge you.
It's on mute. They can't hear you.
Watch it. You're right. You're good at that. But watch it from the bench in the Brit Gymnasium, in the Kelly Bowers Gymnasium tomorrow.
Live.
Don't stay home tomorrow.
It's not going to be cold.
Come out. Spend the $8. The weather's nicer than it's ever been on a Brit weekend. Experience this atmosphere for yourself.
Yeah. But being so cheap.
Woo! Buddy Holly,
36-33,
takes
folks.
A tumble.
We are nearing a tie.
Olseke answers back with his three.
This is quite the matchup, folks.
This is heating up here.
Even Steven, I'd like Mahadi to say.
Mahadi to Dacho. Back to Mahadi. Thought about shooting it. Oh, just about gave it away there. Morin has it. Gets tangled up in a few people's feet. Yeah, what's the call? Flip a coin?
Yeah, flip it. Do it. Some great names on the St. Francis Xavier squad. Massimo Filomeno. Pretty good, eh?
I like that.
Ayo.
Ayo.
Ayo, like Nathan Acapulco. Oh, man. Got some tough handles.
Still, I like Shepherd Hills.
It's a subdivision in my eyes.
For sure. Oh, you know, we just moved out to Shepherd Hills.
How you liking it?
Pretty quiet.
I heard they're building a grocery store out there for you. Okay.
Morin. Oh, 4-3.
39-36. Walter Murray very much in this game now, folks. We have ourselves a basketball game. Minute 40 on the clock. Number 9 can't get her to go.
Ooh,
get him
some
Windex.
Gets a second chance at it.
Cleaning
second
the
time
glass.
He makes it go.
Olseke going to call him Windex.
Washing the glass?
Yeah, just cleaning it up.
Muhammad Yunus. To Dacho, to Holly.
Oh, Holly,
he's gonna put it up.
Oh, the kid
four,
shot from
three.
The cornfield.
Because why wouldn't you?
The other side of Ottawa.
You win the free throw contest. You might as well come. I mean, the 3-point contest. You might as well come in here and shoot
so
the lights
much
out.
So much poise. He's in grade 9.
Seke. This second guy, I like him. He's good.
Yeah, he's good. He's
Eternity.
He's making a push for the All-Star selection. We have no say in that, by the way, folks. So.
No, we don't, and nor should we. Hey, I can see in the corner here, just behind the players,
over,
as we're looking
yes.
in the back corner, I can see our next halftime show waiting in the wings. Next halftime show, BSOFLO. Basso Flow.
Oh. BS, okay, yeah.
You can
okay.
check them out at www.besobad.com.
All right.
Dance group from Be So Bad. I can't wait for them.
No doubt. Not
crowd
just
is
basketball.
Into this game. In case you can't hear it at home, we got a tie game, and the crowd is loving it.
41-41, baby.
Zach
Oh,
Holly.
Look at this.
The grade 9 guard fighting.
He's fighting over the
rebound.
The last peanut butter cookie in the jar. Dave Fisher's giving out hugs. This is pandemonium.
Oh, the feeling in here. I can just feel
it's
the love in here.
It's like
everyone's having a blast.
I don't think there's much love between these two teams right now.
No.
But in the air, I can feel it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Eternity. rebound. How did Mahadi come up with that over Seke? Seke's been swallowing up all those rebounds.
He has. He's been all over the rebounds.
Holly crisscrossing his way, finds Mahadi, no shot. Called on the travel. The St. Francis Xavier bench loves that call.
16.8 on the clock.
Coach Jones stands up and says, I respectfully disagree.
Yeah, I'm sure those are the words that came out. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 16 seconds left, tie game. Oof. And of course, this is only the first half. 16 seconds left in the first half.
We get to do this all over again.
From the corner. No good. Mahadi picks up the rebound. 8 seconds. Time ticking down. Morin, what can he do here with 4 seconds left? Nowhere to go. In the corner.
He was looking for Holly.
Oh, he was looking for Holly. Eunice put it up. Couldn't get it to go. But you're right. His first look, he was looking for Holly. And I wonder why that would be. But Eunice put up a shot in the corner, missed it. That's okay. Tie game at half. This is what we asked for. Oh. What a game so far. Stick around, folks. We got Be So Bad Dance Troupe entertaining us.
It only gets better from here.
Hold on, and second half action after that. You don't want to miss it. Winner of this goes to the semis.
Buckle up.
Good job.
Hey, we are back here. Second half action. 10 seconds in. Dylan Moore just hit a free throw to give Walton Reed their first lead of the game.
Just a little taste.
Okay. But before we talk about this game, and this game is worth talking about, tied at half. St. FX had to lead the whole half. I think as great as maybe 13 points, and Walton Reed came back and tied up. I got to talk about that halftime show.
My goodness, those students, those dancers are talented.
And they're students of dance.
Yeah.
But yeah, that, holy cow, that, wow.
Mind-blowing.
They were like, good.
Yeah, definitely. Best halftime show I've seen so far. And there's been some good ones.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. And I'm no dance judge, nothing like that. But holy cow, I was impressed. High energy. Holy man. Anyway, fun to watch. Crowd was into it. Usually kind of see the crowd. Kind of crowd was like dialed in.
Right. We're getting some requests for some Dilly Bars. I don't think they have them till Saturday.
What?
That's what I heard. We are hydrating up here, thanks to Culligan. Okay, folks. Bada bing. Oh, misses on the layup. Number 11 for Walter Murray. That'd be Muhammad Yunus, grade 12 guard. Hey, Giants says he loves this commentary, and we love Giants.
Yeah, we do. Hey, we try to keep all of our comments here positive and uplifting and fun and all that kind of stuff, and we ask that you do the same thing on the live chat, right? There's a high school tournament. Nothing but celebrations here. We're celebrating the staff, the students, the volunteers, the players, the game.
A dunk.
Look at that.
Celebrate that dunk, why don't you?
Eternity.
I don't want to risk his last name. Aguagi? Maybe.
We're messing it up. Holy! That's a long three. That isn't your average three.
Oh, I see some family of mine entering the fray.
Oh.
We've got young Max with his mom.
Oh, actual family of yours.
Yeah, you're like blood.
Yeah, okay. You're like, would those be your nephews?
Yeah, that would, well, I don't know. Was it second cousin? Whatever. My cousin's kids. They're like my nephews.
Cool.
Yeah. Anyhow, back to the action.
Back to the action. Walter Murray up 3, 46-43. 6 minutes left in the third quarter. Slowing things down just a little bit. Dylan Morin around the outside. Eternity. Swats it away. Get out of here, he says.
Yeah, beat it. And as we move forward here, 46-43, Walter Murray turning the tides on St. FX here.
And Eternity's six, listed at 6'6". Dylan Morin's listed at 5'11". I'd say Dylan Morin's more like 5'10". So we're talking, there's an 8-inch difference there.
Yeah.
Eternity's going to be swatting those all day.
Teams have been known to upsell height
True.
In the program.
You're right. List a little bigger than they really are. Eternity has it from the top. Drives, dishes, the finish by Sean Brodeur. Zach Hawley, Chris Crossan, driving, pull-up jumper.
Oh, in
misses.
And out. Fascinating physics, how that works.
Yeah, because it
was in.
That was below the rim.
Oh,
4-3, Joel Seke.
Seke, he's no joke.
Gets St. FX within one. Morin's got it at the top. Looks cross court to Hawley.
You know, Sides the game's good when I start to stand.
Yes, that is the truth. Muhammad Yunus picks up the rebound from the Zach Hawley shot. Morin has it at the top. Fires it. Misses. Eternity gets the rebound. Fires it.
Oh, smart delay.
Brodeur underneath.
Yep, just waited that out there.
And
patience.
St. FX all of a sudden they're
showing
in the lead.
Patience.
Exchanging leads.
We got ourselves a back and forth seesaw battle here. Right now, this is game of the tourney as far as I'm concerned.
It's so far. Oh, Dylan Morin for three and another long three. You're right. We already saw one game go to overtime. St. Joe's versus Martin from Regina.
Correct. Oh.
This one, this game kind of has overtime written all over it. And
it definitely has a good vibe.
And with
the
amount of fun I'm having watching, I wouldn't mind a few extra minutes of this because this is fun basketball to watch.
Oh, and it's, you know, the gym's full.
Gym's
We've
packed.
Got a great atmosphere here, folks.
Friday night.
We have another day of this.
Good to see 1,000 people or so from Saskatoon community coming out to Bedford Road, the Kelly Bowers Gymnasium, and
yes.
watching some Brit. Love that.
Oh.
Morin for three.
Wow.
And the foul. Jim goes nuts. Possible four-point play.
Oh, this is what I'm talking. Can you see why? Now you're standing.
I am. I just like, this is like, this is.
We
this
might,
is the Brit that I've been wanting for
yes.
the last 3 years
hey,
right
careful.
Here.
Everybody's going to start
this
standing.
This is it.
We might have started a trend.
This is what we paid our $8 for.
I know. Everyone will be standing.
You know what? I forgot to add our two hot dogs to our list here. We did have two hot dogs.
When I went and got us the water, I ate a cookie. Just saying.
You know what? I actually also had a cookie.
As
when
these
we
players
the
burn cows, I'm gaining them.
Oh, your mouth is burning cows.
Oh, it's all about in and out here.
1,000 miles
in,
a minute on those
out.
Chops.
Big rebound, number nine, Seki.
Seki's going to drive it himself, foul.
Ooh. That was foul.
That was, there's.
No, I'm talking
can,
about,
you,
yeah.
call, you call that foul on a couple different people, I think.
Mm-hmm. Most definitely.
Getting a little handsy down there, the Marauders are.
They are. All new shirts for the Volunteers I see this year.
Yeah, new Brit Crew shirts. Sweet.
Dusted off the old ones and said, nah.
Nope, not good enough.
You deserve it.
If Brit's back, we're doing it right.
That's right. 56-50, folks.
Wow. Seke's going to shoot. Hits his first. That's Joel Seki.
Get Dylan Morin here, number 11 for Walter Murray, just lurking in that far corner. Oh
no,
goes.
That's that. Who is that?
Number 11.
Muhammad Yunus. Muhammad Yunus. Yeah, yeah. He's a lurker down low.
Okay. Well,
he can't get him the ball.
Here. Okay. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong. I looked at his grade.
Oh. Whoops.
Formatting. Sorry,
formatting.
Folks. Formatting.
Again, we're going to revisit. No common formatting for the way some coaches submit their rosters.
We
a little confusing.
It, we want it changed. All right. Yunus. Oh.
Whoa. There's Muhammad Yunus.
My goodness.
Drives baseline. Nifty move under the basket.
Right. Right. Number three is Morin.
Yes, right.
Yes.
With the glasses. That's
yeah.
how I remember.
That
Seke. Oh!
Fascinating he plays with them on.
That didn't make a sound.
No. Swish.
Poof.
What a basketball game. This is an absolute treat.
This is a treat to watch. What a way to spend a Friday night. Morin.
My phone is blowing up by means, I mean, I've got one text saying, saying keep it up. Keep up the good work, guys. '58-'57. I talked to the tech crew at halftime and they said that apparently you folks can see the score at home on the live stream.
Morin.
Wow, he is money.
He is money.
Oh, he's automatic.
Morin looking to get more in the basket. Did you see?
Yeah, that was a good one. That was good. Hey. That was good. Just don't get too excited.
Okay.
All right, they're fighting for the ball again. Borderline UFC ground game there. Going for side control.
Oh, we got 61-57, Walter Murray, 4-point lead. Just over
nice.
Two to go in the third.
This is, the time is just going so fast.
Like, it is. Ever since we got back from the half, it's like, what?
It's intense.
This is, oh, it's fast, fun. I'm having a blast here. Seke has it. Cross court.
Whoa.
Nifty pass to Eternity.
Air ball.
Air balls.
Haven't seen
it.
Much of that out of him.
Yunus looking for Holly. Doesn't have it. He's got Morin.
Bedford Road legend, former dance instructor Carolyn Parr here.
She's in the house.
Oh, always one to take in the festivities that are Brit. Here he is, the man, the myth, the legend.
A journey, oh. Roll around.
One man army here.
2-point game.
I'm always fascinated by just watching the coaches and the hand signals and the communication that's happening like mid-game.
Yeah.
I often wonder how much of this the players are actually taking in. They're in the middle of like one of the most intense games they probably ever played in.
It's so
and
loud
the coach
here.
Is giving them, yeah, like hand
how do you
signals.
Hear anything?
I think that's the hand signals. Hmm. But I don't know how much they're absorbing. Wow.
What?
That was from like, yeah, the other side of the river.
From both sides here, this has been a bit of a three-point clinic.
Yeah, definitely. This game is one for the ages, folks. Britt never fails to live up.
Rebound Holly. Tagiri.
Oh, very patient.
Nifty little move.
So patient there.
Yeah, besides being patient is the best way to go. I like that.
I should take that advice.
Yeah.
I tend to rush into things.
You and I both, I think, could take some advice from him. Charge. And the hometown crowd likes that.
Yeah.
That's Abdeh Tagiri.
Yeah, that could be prove costly.
Drawing that one in.
Seki not happy with himself. This carbonated beverage, whose brand I won't name, is delightful.
A cola.
It's delightful.
You know what? I don't drink much sodas at all, but
this
yeah.
This is the first one of the tourney. I needed the little...
I bought a case of cola over the break, and I was like, holy cow, there's something about a can of cola.
I know.
It's good.
Yeah. I don't buy it either, but this is a treat.
Yeah. It's nice.
Oh, refreshing.
68-59 Murray. Murray opening up a bit more of a lead here.
Yeah, they have here, folks.
Oh, off the foot to Tagiri.
Somebody needs to instruct Winnie.
Winona.
Yes.
Out there doing her job like a boss, mopping up sweat from the floor.
She's
had
that,
to be quick. That was
got,
a quick steal
she's
and turnaround.
She's got that hood on. Earth to Winona.
5 seconds left in the quarter. Eternity shoots. No good. Morin gets the rebound. I'll tell you what, we went into half tied at 41. Now at the end of the third quarter, Walter Murray 70, St. FX 59, opening up an 11-point lead.
I'm just laughing about that almost fatal collision we had there with Winona, the floor sweeper, taking her job very seriously. So locked into the zone there, didn't see. The parade of young men coming towards her.
Well, there's a quick turnover here, and then,
yeah.
Like, how fast do these guys run? About, like, 60, yeah. 70 miles an hour or something like that coming
taking,
at you?
Taking pride in keeping that key as shiny as it can be. Wow. Entering the fourth quarter, place your bets on a horse, folks. I don't know. This is out of
how
control.
How you doing? Hey, we got some Hey Baby playing, you know who, Kelly Biff Bowers, the very madness
that was his
gym
jam.
Is named after.
Yes, the legend.
Bedford Road and Brit legend. That
yes.
was always his favorite song. Play Hey Baby, let's go. Let's get that crowd pumped
and
up. And guess
what? The gym would light up.
It does get the crowd pumped up.
It does.
Up.
It's a classic. It's a Brit classic. I'm sure we'll hear it again Saturday night, folks. For those of you that want to know the schedule, I'm sure you can find it online, but the winner of this is going to take on, I believe, Riffle out of Regina tomorrow.
Regina Riffle,
yeah,
3 p.m.
3 p.m.
And then, of course, the semifinal, the other semifinal already decided.
Raymond, yes, out of Alberta.
Versus?
Holy Cross.
Out of Saskatoon.
Yes, the perennial.
No surprise there. Not yes. surprised to see Cross in the Holy in the semifinal.
The perennial invitee.
Morin. Brodeur's licking his chops. He wants to get a hand on the ball. Two guys.
Money Morin.
Morin at 5'10 with 2 6-foot-5 guys in his face puts up a three over top
the
of him.
Kid is
what?
Amazing. Bright
what?
Future. Bright future.
Oh, Eternity answers back with a tray of his own.
And Morin's only in grade 11.
I know.
Having some difficulties
there. Zegarry, oh, manages to take it and shake off two defenders. Down low.
Walter Murray's really locking
Will
into the zone here.
Couldn't get it to go. They are.
Playing off adrenaline.
Picking up some momentum,
yep.
It seems,
got
a little bit.
Got this home crowd.
Started off slow. What do we got here? What's the call?
Carlton lining up, wanting to know what's all the ruckus outside there. Outside their locker room door, Carlton filed into the gym. They don't want to miss a minute of this. Hey, what's going on out there?
Yeah, they're in the locker room. Hey, you know, maybe we should go watch this one. The crowd seems pretty into it. Well, yeah, the crowd's into it, and yeah, you should watch this one.
Right. Maybe we should have the live stream into the locker rooms for them next year.
You can see him on the left side of your screen there, Carlton, just running into the practice gym.
Warm-up gym, yep. The facilities they have here.
Incredible.
Incredible. Morin, way across the continent.
To Geary.
Walter Murray really settling in here in this fourth quarter.
To Morin. Oh, again in and out. And you know, talking about the facilities and the Brit and all this kind of stuff reminded me, I'm going to take a little detraction and I'm going to go, hey, this year, Bedford Road turns 100. This is a 100-year-old facility.
Yeah.
53 years into Brit, 100 years into tradition of this school.
Yep.
Pretty amazing place.
1923.
This is for those
she
of you don't know
her
this.
Doors.
This is the castle on the hill, Bedford Road, right at the top of the hill on Avenue H. And back in the day, before all the trees came in and the houses filled in, this is one of the highest points in the city. You'd be able to look down from your second floor classroom at Bedford Road in 1920 and you'd be able to see the river.
Right.
You see all the way down to sort of city center in Saskatoon. Pretty amazing place with an amazing history. And I'm,
if these floorboards could talk.
You and I are fortunate to be, you know, even just a small part of this.
That's right. Blessed, even.
I would say blessed.
Well, with 75 points on the board, Walter Murray's looking pretty blessed. They're looking to stamp their ticket, punch their ticket even, to the finals, or semifinals, I should say.
75-62, 13-point lead, just over six to go.
They've really been getting stronger as the game's gone on.
It has been. But I think we know that St. FX packs a punch.
They've
and
got
13 points. It's maybe it sounds like a lot with only 6 minutes left and whatever. Like,
It can be done.
It can definitely be done.
These teams have been back and forth all evening here. Pretty full house.
Oh, it is fun. What a night on a Friday night.
It's getting hot
in here.
All right. Back to basketball.
Holly to Dacho Fontaine. Gets hacked. I've been so into the game. I've been paying attention to, like, team fouls, who's got fouls. I don't know.
It's over my head.
There's been a number of fouls this half. That's what I'll say.
You know what? If you're sitting at home watching, just keep track of yourself. Okay?
That's right.
We'll let you know when something big happens.
Morin, a long three. Rebound. It's Eternity who picks it up.
Love the glasses.
Yeah, me too.
Oh.
Three.
Kalen Smith. Yes. He's been quiet. He's heating up, hopefully.
A 6'3", your 8'11" guard.
A big steal.
To Seke. Oh, mishandled. Walter Murray's going to get the. There's. Stole the ball. Who got that? Ayo. Ayo got the steal. Seke kind of bobbled it there. Walter Murray got the ball back. 5.5 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
Bit of a hot potato, that play.
To Geary getting sort of mauled there in the corner. What's the call here? A little foul on Fontaine? Is that what? I missed that one. Either way, St. FX ball. St. FX from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada.
They've been here a few times.
They have been.
The many Brits that I've been involved in, they've been here.
Yeah, this isn't their first time. In fact, they've won this tournament before. I'm looking up at the banner here. 2017, St. Francis out of Alberta won the whole thing. So 6 years ago, 7 years ago, whatever, my math is bad, 6 years ago, they walked away here as champions.
Okay, I would have been in the gym because I'm old.
Yeah, we would have been here.
We were here. Yep.
The years just blend together into one magical cornucopia of happiness.
Yes, just one big Brit, one blur. Oh, we see the Brit crew now marching into the stands, selling goods. And there's more of them hand signals from the coach.
Morin has the ball, 8 seconds on the shot clock. He puts it up. I don't know what to say, and neither does the St. FX coach. He just shrugged his shoulders.
Well, he was waving his hands like he had a question.
Like, what?
And nobody called on him. He knew the answer.
Because I think he's kind of going like, well, how do you stop that?
Oh! I'll tell you how.
Maybe you don't stop it. Maybe you just answer back like eternity
did. They're going to have a few more of those, folks.
Oh.
There he is.
Holly. No good. Tagiri picks up the rebound. Walter Murray holds on to it. To Morin.
They're having fun out here, folks.
Oh. Getting a little chippy. It's getting spicy out here. I like
Always
it. These boys
does.
Are playing with heart. 8-point game.
This is a big one.
St. FX is looking to come back here with 4 minutes left.
The intention, the tension mounts.
I love it. Setting the screen, Zach Hawley bobbles it.
We better not go to overtime. My Uber is near.
Tell him to wait.
I'm gonna lose a point if I cancel.
Charge it to Britt.
Yeah, they got lots of money. Look at this place, it's full. You're telling me they got no money. You're telling me the t-shirts aren't in the budget. Okay, in all seriousness, 78-70.
Oh, what a move, Morin.
Making a move to be on the, lost his glasses, puts him on mid-stride. Love this kid.
Oh, Tagiri with the steal. Whoa, nifty move to shake the defense. Another one, he's gonna go coast to coast. What a play!
Drive of the game.
Effort.
The hair on the back of my knee is standing up.
Oh, wow.
Did I say that out loud? Are we supposed to have hair there?
Gross.
Yeah.
Actually.
It's pandemonium really in here, folks. Timeout.
Wow. 12-point lead for Walter Murray. 82-70. That single-handed effort after the steal from Tagiri.
That was amazing.
That's highlight reel stuff right there.
One of the nicest breaks down court I've seen in a while.
Highlight reel.
Yes. Bring on the slow-mo.
And you know, one thing I noticed about Morin, Dylan Morin, the way he flies around and throws his body around and all this kind of stuff, I don't know why he doesn't get those like straps for his glasses, because that's what got to be the third, fourth time he's lost them.
Yeah, like it's the other gentleman on St. FX, he's got more of like the Charles Oakley style, you know, they're like strapped on.
Yeah, yeah, the Horace Grant.
Horace Grant, Charles Oakley. Did Charles Oakley have glasses too?
Well, I don't know. Charles Barkley, you mean?
I'm just thinking Oakley's because of the glasses.
Yeah, that's
I'm
true.
Confused.
Whatever.
It's hot.
They're words. We're out here, we're saying words.
That's all we're doing.
Sometimes they make sense when put together, sometimes they don't.
Hey, you win some, you lose some. Mm-hmm. And somebody's going to win this match, that's what I know.
Tis the truth.
Yeah.
12-point game.
Yep. The winner of this is off to the semis.
I love overtime. I do. I just love overtime.
And the semifinal will be what tomorrow? So the winner's going to play tomorrow at...
Winner of this plays tomorrow at 3 against Regina Riffle. Ooh. Riffle played earlier tonight.
What time was their game?
They were the 5 o'clock game against Carleton. What a game. And yeah, they look good. And I know I just can't stop talking about this guy, but this 6'8", grade 10 player that they have on Riffle, he's just a monster.
Yeah, it's going to be a good matchup, whomever passes the test here, folks. 8-point
Oh, Muhammad Yunus keeps it in. It's Walter Murray ball, under 3.5 to go. Morin for 3, nope. Fontaine picks it up. Picks up the air ball, puts her in. Back to Murray Ball.
Oh! That was from, like, the cornfield.
That was from the cornfield. Eternity! Oh, captain, a shifty little move there. Brodeur grabbed it. He got fouled when he went up. Whoo! Whoo! Whoa. My heart is beating. You're cutting out just a little. You know what? I think we just might be getting over trafficked on the channel. I think once we hit 1 million viewers at once, we are kind of, some of the things starts to go. Giveaway there.
Good
steal to Eternity. Looking into cutting to that lead. He does. Now it's at 12. They need a few more steals. Whoa, Zach Hawley getting back on defense. Morin shaking up on the play. He went down pretty hard, was slow to get up, even kind of told to Geary to kind of slow down. Don't pass me the ball. I need a sec here. Yep. I can hear you in mine. Yep. Me too, I got a couple little crackles. Little snap, crackle, pop. Switch yowzies. There we go. This button.
You just do it. I got it.
Mahadi.
Okay, I'm back.
He's got it.
Maybe not.
Yeah, you're back, I can hear you.
Okay.
Whew. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Hawley has it. Tagiri. Mahadi.
Oh.
Oh.
Not only am I getting heart palpitations from the intensity of this game, mic issues.
What's next?
I'm back.
You're back.
I feel it. 84-75. My goodness. A minute 21 on the clock. Does
Nine
it get any better?
Point game. It ain't over yet, folks.
The text messages are rolling in.
Pouring in. It's raining.
This is
messages.
Intense. These boys are man children. That's another text message.
And they are man children. Like,
my goodness.
I did not look like this in high school. Like,
wow. They're not going away, folks.
No, they are not. 6-point game. This is two possessions here. And we know St. FX can shoot.
Both teams with two timeouts.
Under a minute to go. Morin's getting swarmed. The giveaway. Eternity.
This is vital. Oh.
Oh, that could have been a real difference right there. But Mahadi has it. Dishes to Hawley. Hawley puts it up. He gets fouled. I think Walter Murray's pretty content to maybe slow things down. Just a touche right now.
Just a touche.
Because I'll tell you what.
That's a smidge.
It's a touche or a smidge.
Yeah, a little bit.
But I'll tell you, it's a different game if Eternity hit that three.
Oh.
Because
totally.
Now we're down to one possession, three
right.
points.
Yeah. That could be like a TSN turning point.
As they call it. Hawley hits his first.
The Brit game breaker.
Coach has got to like that. That makes it a three possession game at least.
A young man's automatic from the charity stripe. 85-78.
Timeout called. Same FX, 45 seconds left in the game. 8-point lead, Walter Murray. Walter Murray, a young, small, skilled team. St. Francis Xavier, pretty balanced team between grade 11s and 12s. A lot bigger than Walter Murray. But as we can see, that hasn't stopped Walter Murray from putting up points and taking the lead here.
What a strong second half. I mean, Walter Murray just felt like they were just getting stronger as the game went on.
I do agree. St. FX kind of
controlled a slow start,
that whole first half, and St. FX was leading right until the last kind of 5 seconds of the first half when Walter Murray tied it up.
And then they came out second half and things were, you know, in control.
Walter Murray came out poised and scoring points.
Balanced. Morin really rose up.
Yeah.
Opened my eyes. I didn't realize he was such a sharp shooter.
Yeah, he's good.
I knew Holly could shoot, but wow.
I didn't realize that. That Dylan Morin is what I would refer to as unassuming. I think, if I was the opposing coach,
he's the kid in my info pro class.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, you need help writing some code. Well, you call Dylan Morin, you know. But actually, I have no idea what he's like as a student. But unassuming as a player. But
he's amazing. Had a great game. Bunch of Murray players had great games. Number 8. Not to be outdone.
Eternity, no good. Fontaine's fighting for the rebound. Who's the foul on? Fouls on St. FX. And Murray's in the bonus, so Fontaine's going to shoot two.
Well. Jim, a little quieter.
It is a little quieter.
Almost too quiet.
Oh, good heart to save that ball. Eternity steps behind the line. Can't get the three to go. He's had a tough minute. I think he's put three or four up in the last minute.
Yeah,
that's
really the difference, you know, when you're leaning on that one player, one or two players to carry you.
Oh,
it seemed like
tough.
Murray had a little more depth. I don't know. The balls bounce their way.
Seke for three.
21 seconds essentially left. I don't know. I mean, 6 points.
Six
it can
point,
happen.
That's two
it
possession.
Happen.
That can happen.
This has happened. Do
Holy
not turn
cow.
Off your monitors, folks. Feel free to mute us, but don't turn off the monitors.
Oh, yeah, music's pumping, crowd's dancing, they're shifting in their seats, clapping along.
Well, I just got the news. You want to know what the news is?
What is the
news? We have 251 concurrent viewers.
Whoa.
And we appreciate every single one of you.
Absolutely,
we
do. Hey, tell your friends,
that number's
spread the word.
Just kept going up.
Britt's back, baby. If you're watching, spread the news. Send those links to your friends. Tweet them out.
Tweet them. Twitter them.
Hashtag them somehow.
Yep. We kind of called that the pound sign when I was a young one.
We did used to call it that.
Yep. Pound sign.
258 viewers. Send it around. Of course, if you're out of town, if you're not inside Saskatoon, we want you on the live stream checking it out, chiming in, telling us about your teams. If you're in Saskatoon watching on the live stream and you have the ability to come down to this gym tomorrow, don't stay home. It's way better in person. You don't have to listen to us. You get to soak up the atmosphere.
That's
grab
right.
yourself a Brit dog.
You might make a friend.
I reckon you will. Yeah, it's better here.
All right. Walter Murray brings a heat to St. Francis Xavier in the Kelly Bowers Gymnasium for Game 10. Hashtag. They're waiting for that final score. They want to set in that post. 87-81. Anything can happen.
Anything can happen.
I've seen it. It's not over. That's the beautiful thing about basketball, you know? You get these final seconds.
Anything can happen.
And it is warm in here.
Oh, yeah. But hey, it's warm outside.
Yes, like no excuse. You cannot blame the weather, people.
No, I would come to Britt, but it's too cold. Too cold?
Yeah, my car
won't
start.
Tomorrow might be the warmest day on Brit record. Isn't tomorrow supposed to be like -5 or
about,
something? Like
I heard about high, but possibly -1.
-1.
The sun shines in the right angle, you're going to see melting.
Holy, in middle of January. This doesn't happen in Saskatchewan.
Well,
it doesn't
maybe it's
happen
the
on Brit
intensity
weekend.
Of Brit heating up the
heating
atmosphere.
Heating up the entire province.
The planet even.
Wouldn't surprise me.
11.3 seconds.
I'm not the best with science, but I think that checks out.
Do the math. Run the numbers. Put it through the model, the simulator, whatever they do.
but have
we ran the numbers. Well, this crowd got their money's worth, folks.
Did they ever. They would have got their money's worth if this was the only game of the night, but it wasn't. There was five games before this. We still got one coming up after.
I'd pay $8 for this.
Yes. Oh. Where do you get that kind of bang for your buck
big
for
lot.
Entertainment? $8 and you get to spend the day checking out some of the best basketball you ever see. Halftime shows galore.
He missed that last free throw. That it hurt.
That does hurt.
Because it would have been a three-point game.
Look at this.
Wow.
One possession game, folks. 10 seconds left. Walter Murray, 87. St. FX, 84.
Don't turn away.
Oh, she ain't over. She ain't over.
So that fat lady, she's got to sing. I don't know what she's singing.
Me neither.
She hasn't sung yet.
Oh, no, she ain't singing yet. This game is not over. Both teams in bonus territory. 9.4 seconds left. Walter Murray's going to get a chance to inbound the ball here.
Okay, well, your Uber has arrived. My Uber can wait.
Journey's got the crowd singing.
This is the victory song that they play at the Red Wings home games.
Is it really?
Yes.
Now, you know what I'm going to say.
Is this now the Walter Murray victory song?
No, that they don't play that song very often.
Played it the other night against the Leafs.
Oh, that's
Take
right,
that.
They did.
Hadn't beat him in like 5 years.
I'll always cheer against the Leafs. I'm with you. Go Red Wings.
Well, you're a Habs fan. Oh, what's going on? Holly, is this legit?
This is legit. There was...
He's pulled something.
There's a pretty decent knee contact there. I'm not at all suggesting that it was on purpose.
It looked to be
incidental. They're both going for the ball, but...
Okay, well, Holly's got to play tomorrow.
Yeah, he needs to play tomorrow. He's a big piece of this team.
Okay.
Okay, that's got to make the Walter Murray coaches breathe a little easier. Now we got a two-possession game.
8.7 seconds on the clock. There's a hush over the gym.
There is a hush that came over the gym.
Nervous energy. Oh, my. Squeezing every last second out of this. Jeez, they want their money's worth, huh?
Yeah, they do.
My goodness.
And we're getting it.
Whew, good thing I'm wearing natural fibered clothing because I'm breathable here. Having a discussion with a Bedford student about, aren't you hot? I said, this is cotton.
It's breathable.
You'd be a fool to be sitting in this gymnasium with synthetics on right now. I can see the people. They're sweating. Mistake number one. You're not wearing natural fibers.
See, so far, I mean, Martin from Regina, St. Joe's went to overtime. I know they went to overtime, but that was a B-side game.
Right.
As far as I'm concerned, this is the game of the tournament so far.
Most definitely. I mean, this has been such a back and forth seesaw battle the first half. Murray clawing back into it and then sort of taking a stranglehold in the third and the first half of the fourth quarter. And then St. FX climbing right back into it. I mean, this is a fantastic game. You couldn't have asked for more. Mm-hmm. We had dunks. Three-pointers?
Tons of three-pointers.
I swear there was some UFC going on at one stage.
There was a few tackles. Double leg takedown one time in the third quarter. Seke. Oh, he gets it! 3.9 seconds left. Seke hits a three to put St. FX within 2 points. Wait, what's the... Okay, there it is. Now it's on the score clock.
Wow. Still having mic issues. Ah.
Wow.
This is crazy.
Like, wow. This serious. Like, wow.
We are witnessing history here.
3.3 seconds, and like I can safely say the game isn't over.
No.
The game is not over.
We've seen this before.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh. The Walter Murray coaches can't believe this. They are. Kirk Jones is rubbing his head. Coach Hawley looking a little redder than usual. 3-point game. 3 seconds left. We're going to get a chance for one last shot. Here it is. Doesn't go. Walter Murray Marauders
hang
with
on.
The win.
90-87. Wow. What a finish.
90-87 at the butt.
Put that in the books.
What?
One of the best games.
What a game. I'll tell you, folks, if you got to watch that, we got a treat tonight. These boys put on a show.
A show. A spectacle.
Holy,
it was insanity.
This is what we're talking about for Britt. Okay. Hey.
Let's tidy things up here.
Wow.
Let the fans know what's happening.
Let's pencil Walter Murray Collegiate into the semifinal tomorrow against Regina Riffle.
Yes, Riffle.
This
Riffle.
Is a Saskatchewan battle. I want to know, when I look, okay, tomorrow, if you're looking A-side, Saturday, tomorrow at 1:30,
yep,
the
Holy
first
Cross.
Semifinal, Raymond versus yep. Holy Cross, the second semifinal at 3 o'clock tomorrow, Riffle versus Walter Murray Collegiate. I can't recall a time we had three Saskatchewan teams in
final
the semifinals.
Four. Yeah.
Three out of the final four. Our Saskatchewan teams, two from Saskatoon,
this
one from Regina.
This could be an all-Saskatoon final.
Tune in. Hey, if you're listening from Regina right now or watching,
get
drive
your ass
down
in
tomorrow.
The car. Yeah, drive up here. Come on.
Get going. Hey,
we'll buy you a Brit Dog.
Are we signing off for the night
We're
here?
We're signing off. We have some other commentators calling the next game. We will talk to you all tomorrow.
Peace.